such a thief. All my broken pieces, every load that's carried.
My name is Candace Blanks, and I'm talking to those people who have been afflicted, abused, rejected, feeling unloved, or just simply gone through life and don't have a way out. Or maybe you have been diagnosed with an illness. Well, I'm here to tell you that God is here for us, and He is healing the broken. So please tune in every day to Healing for the Broken as various people tell and share their heart and testimony.
How will you feel when you know that someone is praying and interceding for you every day? That is how we hold our partners with high esteem, standing in the gap and praying for you without season. NDTV is God's plan to transform lives and help people to get their freedom from every form of oppression, walk in victory, discover their original destiny and the plan of God for them. Together, we can do far more than any of us could ever do alone. Become a partner today by visiting www.ndtvn.com/partnership, and you will be glad you did.
NDTV, where this show is for those people who have been down and out and looking for restoration. Well, this is the place, and we're here just knowing that God can heal the broken. I'm your hostess, Candace Blanks, and you are in for a treat. God says that He is here to heal those who are broken.
And let somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Houston, are you ready? Get ready to meet the man that God has used to attract a crowd of over 3 million in one single gathering. A man whom God has used to lead the fastest growing denomination all over the world in a night of divine encounter.
But whenever the fire of God falls, there's one thing fire does, and it does it very well. It burns. And so on the authority of the Almighty God, that in the life of every one of you, suffering will be over.
A night of total restoration and baptism by the fire of the Holy Ghost with Pastor E.A. Adeboye, the General Overseer of the Redeemed Christian Church of God Worldwide, a church with parishes in over 190 countries of the world. You are invited to join thousands in a night of supernatural encounters, the Houston Festival of Life, tagged Let the Fire Fall. Ministering Pastor E.A. Adeboye, March 21st, 2018, starting at 6 p.m. Venue, Texas Southern University Basketball Arena, 3100 Cleburne Street, Houston, Texas, 77004. For more information, contact the FOL Media Team at 281-728-6173. There will be free parking, so come and encounter the fire of the Holy Ghost, bringing out the best in your life and home. Be there.
Such a thief, all my broken pieces, every load that's carried.
My name is Candace Blanks, and I'm talking to those people who have been afflicted, abused, rejected, feeling unloved, or just simply gone through life and don't have a way out. Or maybe you have been diagnosed with an illness. Well, I'm here to tell you that God is here for us, and He is healing the broken. So please tune in every day to Healing for the Broken as various people tell and share their heart and testimony.
Oh,
healing for the broken. Well, we have our first guest, Miss Montrea Bailey, who's going to actually, before we start, give us her gift of song.
Wow, thank you for having me, and I appreciate this opportunity to be on Healing for the Broken. I suppose I can just sing a cappella.
You can sing a cappella.
Okay. This is a song that I sung for many years when I first came back to God. It's a simple song. It talks about the power of praise and how God can change your life just through praise. Well, you know, I'm a praiser. You're a praiser, sister?
Oh, I'm a praiser,
I know, that's right. We're over here praising the Lord.
Yes, we are.
The name of this song is I Won't Complain. And it's simple. It says, I've had some good days. I've had some hills to climb. I've had some weary days. Some sleepless nights. But when I look around, I have to think things over, even though I can't walk this all of my good days, I weigh my bad days, and I won't complain. See the Lord, He's been good to me. And he's been good to me, more than you or my doctors will ever be. He's been so good to me, and he dried all of my tears away. Today. So I want to say, thank you, Lord. I want to say, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. I won't complain.
Amen. Amen. Listen here, I don't know about you guys, but I felt the anointing of God in this place. Just knowing that you don't complain about what God is taking you through. You just pay your way through it. We'll be right back after these messages.
This is your favorite show, The Spotlight Show with Sam Hudson on NDTV. With interactions, revelations, family issues. Success and comeback stories. Inspirations. Life lessons. Prayers and invitations. Passion for the lost souls. Much more on The Spotlight Show. For past episodes, visit www.ndtvn.com for Edward Sponsorship and to be a guest on this show. Email sam@ndtvn.com.
Well, welcome back. I don't know if you're just now tuning in, but Miss Montrea gave us an anointed worship song, I Won't Complain. And I'm telling you, I won't complain. This is Healing for the Broken. And again, I'm your hostess, Candace Blanks. And this is our guest, Miss Montrea. How you doing, Miss Montrea?
I'm ready to come up out this wheelchair right now.
I know, that's right.
Right now.
Well, listen here. The reason why you were brought on the show was because I know you personally, but they don't know you like I know you, right? So we definitely want to sit here and let people know why and how you got through your trials and the different things that have gone through your life. Let everyone know your testimony.
Well, you know, it all began years ago. I've always sung, I've always done music, and okay. I got into the music industry, and I had a really good run of music. You know, I knew God, but I didn't really know him, and I didn't really have, I had daily, I went to church every week, and I went to prayer meeting as a child, but I didn't have an experience. And so I was singing in the music industry without that connection, and I got lost. I at the time I was walking, I was healthy and strong, but and I got caught up in drugs, alcohol, and I met someone in the music industry, a woman, and she introduced me to the lesbian lifestyle. Mm-hmm. And so I was living that proudly, you know, I was living that boldly. And it was so encouraged and welcomed in the music industry to be gay, to be homosexual, to cross-dress, to be trans. And, you know, I just really got lost in it. And God's grace allowed me big opportunities, but how many of us know that it don't matter how big the opportunity you get, if you ain't living right, eventually he gonna yank that chain.
That's
you know
what I'm true, saying? That's
he gonna yank it.
That's
he's
true.
Gonna yank it. And so, you know, I at the height of my secular music career, I had the opportunity, I was gonna sign a big deal, I was really excited. And I had to go to the doctor because I was having some falls and some problems. I didn't know if I was, you know, I had some cramps or muscle problems. I didn't know what was going on. So I went to the doctor, and the doctor said, "Well, we hate to tell you this, but you have muscular dystrophy. It's a crippling disease. You're going to lose the ability to walk. Your music career is basically over. There's not much we can do for you. We're just going to manage it so that you don't harm yourself anymore."
Wow. Wow.
So, girl, you can imagine I done worked all these years to make it in music. You telling me I ain't gonna walk?
But you're not gonna walk, right? But girl. as you guys saw, her music ability and career is not over. So keep going.
So, I became depressed. You know, a despair came over my life, a depression. And I mean, I locked myself in the house. I would not leave. I didn't want anybody to see me in a wheelchair. I didn't want anybody to see me feeble and weak. I was embarrassed. I was humiliated. And it just got lower and lower, but I wouldn't let go of the women. I was depressed, but I wasn't ready to let go of sin. You know, I didn't understand that there was a correlation between being so low and the sinful lifestyle. I didn't recognize that. I wouldn't engage that conversation with God. I was just gonna do what I was gonna do.
So let me ask you a question.
Mm-hmm.
So that means that you wasn't born thinking the way of wanting to be a lesbian. It just happened.
Right. I really was introduced to it through the music culture.
Mm.
You know, I do think that there are people who early in life, 2, 3, 4 years old, that spirit comes into them and that demonic spirit takes over. And so we know that demonic spirits are very strong. They are strongholds. So that's why you can see a 3-year-old, you know, and the old folks used to say, he's going to be sweet. Mm-hmm. Well, that's because that spirit has already grabbed a hold of that child. But we know we're born into iniquity. We're born into sin. But you are not born gay. You are born with a purpose in Christ. Okay.
So as y'all can see, you're not born gay.
No.
You're just born into iniquity that caused, and that sin just manifests within inside of you to cause you to go into that lifestyle. Yes. Is that correct?
That's what happens. We are born into demonic surroundings. Mm. And some of us latch on to certain things. Mm. You know, some kids, they 3 years old, they are already prolific liars. You know, some children are just, they talk back. They have a rebellious spirit. Yeah. You know, but in my case, I was introduced to it later on in life through a culture that was already sinful. The music industry is just sinful. You know, and so once she introduced me to the lifestyle, and she and I became lovers. We were lovers for many years. And that's where the drugs and the alcohol came. So these, you know, that lifestyle attracts certain things. So it attracts lust, it attracts sex. And so when I got back to Houston and I was dealing with this disability and this handicap, I didn't want to let the women go. And I happened to meet someone you and I both know. Her name's Pastor Sarah.
Okay. Yes.
And Pastor Sarah heard one of my CDs. And on that CD was an R&B CD, but there was one or two gospel songs. And Pastor Sarah said, "You know what? I know that you're thinking about leaving music, but I think you really should sing gospel." And
amen.
I was like, "Girl, Pastor."
So even though you were in sin, God still allowed people to come your way to say, "Hey, listen, it's not over for you." So those people who are out there in this type of lifestyle, God is knocking at the door. Yes. It's up to you to let them in.
Yes.
So you allow Pastor Sarah to come in to say, "Hey, listen, Well, you might gave me an idea.
Yeah. And you know, sometimes gay people or people in sin, we push the church away and we push Christians away because there's a small batch of Christians that sometimes make all Christians look bad, and there's judgmental Christians that make all, but there are good Christians out here that want to see everybody come into the faith. So when she said to start singing gospel, I was really apprehensive, but I didn't have any other opportunities because no one in music wanted to work with me anymore.
Yeah.
And so she said, I know these two people, the key in prosperity, and you need to hook up with them, and you need to go out there with them and do, because they do concerts almost on a weekly basis. I was like, oh my gosh, what if they don't like me? You know, what if they don't like me because I look like a man?
Wow.
You know? And so we met, I'll never forget it, at a hotel. I sang in a hotel. She brought me to sing to meet you guys.
Yes.
And when I sang, the spirit began to move, and Prosperity started crying. And I said, well, I hope she likes me because she's crying right now. So I don't know if that means that I'm doing really bad or really good.
Now, if you don't know who the key is, all my broken pieces, every load that's carried. The key in prosperity is.
That's you!
Well, listen, I am a poet,
right,
and I'm prosperity. My husband is the key.
Right.
And so we're the key to prosperity.
Right.
So when we first met Miss Montreal, she did not look like this.
No.
At all. Miss Montreal had the appearance of a guy.
Yeah.
She was a transgender when we first met her. Oh my goodness, God. I feel your presence right now. Miss Montreal looked just like a man.
Like your husband.
Just like my husband. She had the bald fade. Yeah. She had the boyish clothes.
Oh,
Miss Montreal looked just like a guy. And when we met her, the spirit of God we saw in her life was what she didn't see in her life. And so we saw her through God's eyes, as other people saw her through the eyes of the world.
Right.
But we saw her through God's eyes.
Right.
God put on our spiritual lenses to see who she was on the inside. So we went past the boyish look. We went past how she looked and everything. And we just loved on her, because that's how God is. God is love. So he'll love us in spite of what we have gone through and what has happened in our life. God said, I still love you. Even if you committed adultery or committed this type of sin, any type of sin, because no sin is greater than the other. So keep going, Miss
Girl. Okay, now wait a minute. I'm going to stop shouting out loud. But you know, I love what you said, because that's so true. And you all took me under your wing. And for the first 3 or 4 years, I was just with you guys all the time. And you know what I loved about you all? You all never said, you know, you need to change your clothes, you need to grow out your hair. Y'all just took me as I was. And over time, gradually, I began to change. And after a while, the Spirit of God, I didn't want to look like no man no more. Girl, I would have got me a wig. Right? I would have got me some wigs, girl.
Yeah.
I ain't know nothing about wearing no wigs, girl. I come out there, the wig cocked to the side. The wig had my boy falling off. You know, I didn't know how to put lashes on. I'm talking about lashes to be down here, girl. But you know, I just kept trying.
Yes.
And I kept learning, and I'd go sometimes to sing. And sometimes y'all would have a lot of singers, and I wouldn't be able to sing, but I stayed anyway. So I wanted to listen to other testimonies, and I wanted to listen to the word, and I wanted to listen to how God could change me.
Yes.
And after a while, you know, the testimony started, well, I'm in a wheelchair and God is helping me. You know, that's how it started. That's a safe, fun, non-offending testimony, right?
Yes.
I got comfortable in that one, girl. Oh, yeah. I'm in a wheelchair. How do you? God does say.
So you got more reliant on the testimony of you being in a wheelchair versus you being set free from homosexuality.
Yeah, because I ain't want to offend nobody.
Do y'all hear that? see, a lot of times a lot of people get comfortable in just this one testimony, but they don't tell, or the, as we call it, the naked truth about who they are and what God has delivered them from.
Right.
They only tell you parts of it. And so you got comfortable.
I got comfortable, and everybody was clapping and amen and falling out. And I was like, oh, this is nice. I can, you know, this is easy. And the Lord's like, no, you know, you've got to really dig deep. And you need to tell people how I delivered you from wanting to be a man, living as a man, engaging in sexual relationships with women. You need to tell people, and then you need to tie that into how I used an affliction and suffering to get you out. You see, everybody can't digest that.
So, because that kind of hit me when you say, God used an affliction And so it can be your testimony. Elaborate on that.
You know, we think of God as a give me everything good God, and he's always going to bless me. And no, there's going to be suffering. Yeah. There's going to be affliction. And sometimes he uses suffering to bring us back to him.
Amen.
Because if we always got the record deals, if we were always on national television, if we were always in stadiums, we wouldn't listen to anybody.
Exactly.
But when you're singing in front of two people, when you're out here feeding the poor, nobody's clapping for you, and these are the things that you all taught me. You know, it's not time to sign an autograph. It's time to get out here and minister to the poor. You
Amen.
All used to take me to the projects, and you all used to feed the small kids in the ghetto who didn't have food. You all weren't giving them steak. You gave them what you had. So I think the first night, I bet you y'all was giving them chili dogs. Baby, them churros came up out their apartments. They were so happy to get a hot meal. But, you know, that taught me that you're not always going to be applauded. Sometimes you got to go low. Mm. And God's going to take you into suffering and poverty. And you're
going
to be able to connect with people that, you know what, she's in a wheelchair. We're over here. We don't have no food. We have something in common with her. She's suffering and we're suffering. But the difference between us and her, she got a smile on her face.
Exactly.
And so
Amen.
Once I begin to take that out.
Your feet, all my broken pieces, every load that's carried.
My name is Candace Blanks, and I'm talking to those people who have been afflicted, abused, rejected, feeling unloved, or just simply gone through life and don't have a way out. Or maybe you have been diagnosed with an illness. Well, I'm here to tell you that God is here for us, and he is healing the broken. So please tune in every day to Healing for the Broken as various people tell and share their heart and testimony.
Church that didn't want to hear that. Don't you dare get out here and tell people that God allows people to put people in wheelchairs.
Wow.
But it's in the Word. We have a whole book of the Bible.
So you telling me that the church
says
don't tell your testimony about that.
Mm-mm. Just get out here and tell them the good part.
Just the good part.
Yeah, don't tell them the other part.
So everybody out there, if you're listening,
right,
there are going to be some people to tell you not to tell your testimony,
mm-hmm.
but you have to do what God says
right.
to do. Thus says the Lord. And so in the process, you say, hey, I have to say what God has told me.
I have to. And we have a lot of Pharisees and sanctified folks that mm-hmm. are on another level, but God wants us to be on just everyday folks. Not, you know, you don't have to act not saved, but you need to be able to communicate with those who are not saved.
Amen.
You know? And so I just began to tell the truth. And you know, I used to be able to walk, and God had to get my attention with a wheelchair, and it hurt my feelings. You know, we don't like to talk about how God, sometimes we are hurt towards his will in our lives, but sometimes there's hurt behind that.
That is so true.
But what I love about that is once he brings you out of the hurt, girl, where I am now, honey, girl, people just out there, people that, it's no way she's really handicapped, she's faking it. And I didn't think I'm faking it because I'm so filled with joy and peace.
And she is.
You know, I'm filled with
every
joy
time.
And peace because he's taking me out of the loneliness. Now I'm up on a different, but he still got me in the wheelchair. You know, we still doing some work.
Amen.
We still doing some work.
So in saying that,
yeah,
God has taken your ministry
mm-hmm.
of being set free from a transgender lifestyle to a full-blown, beautiful woman
all
of
right.
God. Hey, now, right?
Hey.
So to all my brothers.
Sanctify.
But sis, you just came back from Austell, Georgia
right.
on a movie premiere. Now, listen to her testimony before.
Right, right.
She said that the doctors told her her career, everything that she dreamed about was going to be over. But God says, I know the plans that I have for you. It is to prosper you
right.
and not to harm you. So in that case, God says, since you came into who the realization
right,
of who you are,
right.
I got this planned
right,
for you.
Right.
So you just came back from Austell, Georgia
right.
on tell us about your movie premiere, right, and everything, the name of it, and what is it all about? Well, what was the purpose of it?
What's so awesome about this is God did, he took me full circle, because this would be my second film. My first film I did when I was not saved, and it was a film promoting homosexuality. That was 13 years ago.
Wow.
And I never thought I would ever do another movie. I never thought I would be invited to do anything like that. And a year ago, I got a phone call. Well, I got a message. We've heard about your testimony. We want you to do a movie, but we're going to be promoting Deliverance.
Homosexuality. Glory, God.
Deliverance. So 13 years later, I get to do a new movie. Same subject matter, but different sides of the spectrum.
Oh,
right?
Wow.
The name of the movie is Here's My Heart.
Here's My Heart.
It's 12 people who were in bondage to homosexuality, transsexuality, bisexuality. And it's just a testimony. I saw the movie. I didn't know what to expect. Girl, it's a movie that's through this roof. It's unlike anything you've ever seen.
Wow.
And I just thank God, because it's not over. It's not over. Sometimes, you know, you think that you're never going to get this opportunity. It's not that. You have to do it God's way. And if you do it God's way, sometimes it takes longer. Because anybody can get out here and hang off a pole with their rear end out. Of course you're going to get opportunities like that. Mm-hmm. But if you do it the right way,
amen,
it takes time. So I just praise God. Ooh, girl, I'm so happy I don't know what to do. I just thank him. I'm going to church tonight. I'm telling the testimony at church about how God turned your life around.
Amen.
And that's really healing for the broken.
Amen.
That's exactly what that is.
So if you can look into this camera, mm-hmm, and you talk to those people who have been where you've been, mm-hmm, from the transgender lifestyle, mm-hmm, to deliverance, mm-hmm, healing the broken, and just talk to the people and just tell them, just give them encouragement and just give them God in you.
The first thing I would like to say is that if you don't have the desire, the Bible teaches us that if you have the love of Christ, you just need the love. And that love is going to translate into so many other things. And really, that's what happened with me. I had the love of Christ in me. And over time, gradually, you don't worry about who's going to be my friend. You don't worry about who's going to like me. God is going to send you these things and these people, just like it happened to me. You know, it starts with one person, and it spreads to prosperity, Candace and her husband. You have to believe and have faith that God has a plan for you in his kingdom. Now, we know Satan has a plan for you, because you might be living it now, and that plan is wonderful. It's great. People clap for you. But you want to believe and have faith that you have a plan in his kingdom, and then let things come together. Now, you're going to lose friends. You're going to have people that are going to try to talk you out of it. Everyone tried to talk me out of it. So many people tried to talk me out of it. Don't do it. You're not going to have any support. No one's going to support you. No one's going to invite you anywhere. But I had faith after a while of suffering. I had no choice but to have faith that God was going to come in. And if you have faith that God is going to come to you, you don't have to be the perfect person. You saw how I looked when I started singing. I was just tore up. But over time, gradually, those doors and those opportunities and those people and that life that he wants for you is going to be revealed. And girl, there's no stop. Now I'm just waiting to get, I'm ready to get up out this thing, honey. That's going to be the next thing. And you were there not too long ago when I did get up and stand.
Yes.
At an event, and I started to, my faith is starting to take me more than that.
Yes. Speaking of faith. Mm. We talk about faith, the faith the size of a mustard seed. What can faith do for a person if only they believe?
I'm trying to tell you, it can do something. I mean, I'm almost emotional thinking about this, because it just takes you to a whole nother level. People said I would never sing again. I would never have opportunities. And a couple of years after meeting you guys and you guys working with me and helping me out, well, I was on national television with the sixth season of BET Sunday Best. And even though I wasn't fully into my calling and I wasn't fully delivered, the grace of God says, you know what, because I see you have faith, I'm going to give you the opportunity. I'm going to give you the opportunity. Now, when I got out there, the Lord said, okay, that's enough. You're not ready yet. Come on home. You know what I'm saying? But that was his way of showing me, a wheelchair ain't nothing for me, honey.
A
wheelchair ain't nothing for me. You not being able to walk ain't nothing for me. You look like a man, that's nothing for me. But because you believe, because you have faith in me, I can work with that. See, he can work better with a sinner who believes and has faith than he has for these sanctified people that are so self-absorbed that their faith is in themselves. And I think that was his thing with me. You know you're a sinner, but you believe.
Yes.
You know you're sincere. And so I think sincerity takes you a long way, and it leads you to things like prosperity. It leads you to things like opportunity. And really, that's where it starts with, is faith.
Faith. Amen. Amen. If you don't get anything else out of this program, just know that you got to have faith and you have to trust God in every part of your life. No matter if you are in a place now where you feel that like there's no way out, but just know there is through the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. This is Candace Blanks with Healing for the Broken, and we'll be right back.
How will you feel when you know that someone is praying and interceding for you every day? That is how we hold our partners with high esteem, standing in the gap and praying for you without season. NDTV is God's plan to transform lives and help people to get their freedom from every form of oppression, walk in victory, discover their original destiny and the plan of God for them. Together, we can do far more than any of us could ever do alone. Become a partner today by visiting www.ndtvn.com/partnership, and you will be glad you did.
My name is Candace Blanks, and I'm talking to those people who have been afflicted, abused, rejected, feeling unloved, or just simply gone through life and don't have a way out. Or maybe you have been diagnosed with an illness. Well, I'm here to tell you that God is here for us, and He is healing the broken. So please tune in every day to Healing for the Broken as various people tell and share their heart and testimony. Welcome back to Healing for the Broken, as we are speaking and talking and having an awesome time in God with our guest, Montrea Bailey. And as of right now, Miss Montrea, she is an awesome singer, an awesome woman of God, but she's also a newly upcoming author to the book, The Gift, the Curse, and the Escape of Sodom. From Sodom, correct?
Yes, my escape from Sodom.
So tell us about this book that's coming out this year.
Wow. You know, I was in the studio one day and I heard God say, write. And I was like, okay, I can write a song, God, no problem. I can write me a song. That's easy. And he was like, no, I want you to write a book. And I was like,
me, God, I don't know anything about writing a book, God. I'm not an author.
I don't know anything about it. And I was really hesitant. I was apprehensive. I didn't want to do it. Mm-hmm. And the Lord's voice was just so loud. It's like, no, you need to write this book. And so I began writing a book called My Escape from Sodom. And it just starts out from as a child and being introduced to Christ and how really your gift can be a blessing and a curse. Mm-hmm. If you use it the wrong way, it's going to be a curse. Even if you make a lot of money, because a lot of people out here are using their gift improperly. And they making a lot of money. They think, oh, God is blessing me. God, no, honey, God, I'm not blessing that mess. God is not blessing that mess.
Yes.
You know, and so my gift was, I used it wrong, so it was a curse.
Yes.
And so I talk about in the book how I went through the curse era and how even though I had a lot of fans, there was a lot of struggle behind the scenes. There was a lot of addiction behind the scenes, substance abuse behind the scenes. There was things that people didn't see on stage.
Oh,
you know, they're
wow.
just seeing this person up there, clap, 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 clap. They don't see me, you know, in between, because I was a DJ as well. They didn't see me,
yeah.
you know, in the gay club. I used to DJ and I'd get the dance floor going. They didn't see me go to the bathroom and do a couple of lines of cocaine. They didn't see me popping ecstasy afterwards. You know, they didn't see that side. And so it talks about getting out of that. And it talks about these chance meetings that I had with people like you and your husband and Pastor Sarah and other people in the Houston community, and how they just welcomed me in, and how over time I just learned, you know, I really think it's important, and you can speak to this as well, that we have women of God in our churches as role models. Mm-hmm. You know, a church, I do believe that the church was meant to be led by men. I just believe that. That's what the word says, that the word, the man is, we are his helpmate. Mm-hmm. So I do believe that. But in my church, we had evangelist women that are allowed to speak and provide the word.
Yes.
And I got to see their perspective on what women of God should look like and what they should be doing. You know, women of God should not, with all due respect, be walking around here taking on the male role. We are not to dress and present ourselves as men, is what I was doing.
Yes.
And so
let me stop you right
there.
Ahead. So a lot of times people have a perception of, well, no woman should wear pants
right.
or any of those different things.
We're not gonna take it that far.
Yeah, but in that aspect of it is no woman should look
like
a man or be a man like the way that you were portrayed to be when you was in the transgender
lifestyle. There's a difference between being a woman who puts on a pantsuit, and there's a difference between being a woman who thinks she's a man. It's a complete difference. And really, it goes back to that spirit. Because people used to say, well, are you saying that if I have short hair, that means that I'm want to be a man? No. It's the spirit behind what you're doing.
The motive.
I knew why I was cutting off my hair. I was cutting off my hair to get me a woman. I was cutting off my hair because that was the latest. You know, and so that spirit, and to have women... Because men sometimes can't speak to that, to what women should be doing in the body of Christ, because they're men. Mm-hmm. And so to go to a church where women just work with me, no one made any comments about my lifestyle. It was all within the context of the word. Mm-hmm. And so when you bring it out in the word, there's love in it. Yeah, it's going to cut sometime, because the Bible says it's going to cut like a two-edged sword. So it's going to hurt sometimes.
It's going to hurt.
Your feelings don't get hurt sometimes. The love is out of love.
It's out of love.
And over time, you know, girl, I didn't know nothing. You used to see me, you and your husband used to see me out here with some of these crazy outfits I had on, talking like a woman. Girl, I looked crazy. But you know what? I was trying. I really wanted to be free in the spirit. Just now I can rock it now. I can rock it, girl. I'm here today. Yes. I can rock it now. But that spirit, and I think
we watched her transition from the guy to the girl, and it was a blessing to us, because we was like, God, she's being set free and delivered. Ooh. She's actually being healed from her broken state of where she was.
Right.
But at the same time, we saw that she was trying.
Right, I was trying.
You was trying. And
you know what I love about you all? Y'all never made a big deal out of it. And then sometimes we just don't want people to make a big deal, because you just want to make it a natural. It's between you and God. But y'all were encouraging, and you weren't like, girl, that weird girl. You need to get another one, you know? But yeah, I love what you did, what you all did. And I mean, how was it? I'm just gonna ask you this quick question. I mean, did you all feel like, you know, we should say something? Or did you feel like we're just gonna let her go, you know, go her own pace? Or what was your deal with that?
Well, you know what? A lot of times, and this is a show of brilliance, right?
Okay.
And so it's healing the broken. The thing is, when we first saw you, a lot of times people say, oh, I got homophobia. My husband Reggie and I never had homophobia.
Right.
We always knew to love people where they're at.
Right.
And so we was like, okay, well, Lord, this woman is an awesome, talented woman, but she's living a lie. The devil comes to lie to you so you can stay in that lie.
Right.
And so instead of, you know, just really just coming and just trying to embarrass you or trying to front you out like that, it was more of, let's love her where you're at.
Yeah.
Because our pastor at Spirit of Life, our pastor Jerome Pastor Nelson, always say that you got to love people. He always teaches us to love people. And so when we met you, it was like, okay, this is the prime example, is to love people where they're at. And so when we was loving on you, and our kids love,
I know.
Oh my goodness, we have four kids and they love them. And at the time, she was Miss Money.
Right.
But God delivered that Miss Money to Miss Montria, her actual birthday. And so when God transitioned, and when my husband and I really just saw your transition, we was rejoicing. Oh, I know that when times when we don't talk or we got a lapse in time, it seemed like when we come back together, there's no lapse in time, right? And so when we saw you transitioning, we was rejoicing at home. We was like, oh, thank you, Jesus. When we saw the wigs and the women outfits, we was like, God, because this is a woman that we saw for years wearing suits and fades and all these different things. Right. And so when to see you go from how God is bringing you out, it was a blessing for us, sis. It really was.
This was like such a spiritual homecoming for me. And I was going to tell you this afterwards, but I'm going to tell you this now. In the movie, Here's My Heart, there's a part where I talk about going back to singing gospel, and I talk about, you know, meeting Candace. I know what we call her prosperity, because every time we have a church raffle or a church giveaway, she wins everything. And in the movie, I talk about meeting prosperity, and I talk about how that meeting really was the catalyst for so many things. So I just thank you, sis. Came together, and this is such a wonderful time in God. You know, I typically don't cry. I feel like crying now, but you just never know when the person God sends you is going to set you on a highway that takes you so far. So I thank you.
You're welcome. And I didn't even know. You know, and that's the thing, people. You are the church that some people sees, and the only church that some people get. Mm. So however way that you're living your life, live it to God and the standards. God says the Galatians 5, the fruits of the Spirit, those are God's characteristics. Love, number one. Joy, peace, long-suffering, gentleness, kindness. Those different things is what people need to see that's coming through you. You can say that you're a Christian, but when you start living and showing people that you love them unconditionally, no matter how they may look or feel, or so whatever you see them do, you love them throughout it. And so that is truly a blessing for me, Miss Montrea, how you're saying these different things, because this is truly a blessed moment for me. Yes. And I truly appreciate everything that you're doing.
Yes, thank you so much. And I just want to let everybody know the book will be out later on this year.
Okay.
So just pray for me, and the movie will be out. Pray for me. A mixtape will be out called Transformer.
Awesome.
And if anyone wants to get in touch with me, the best way is just go on your computer, type in that name, Montrea, M-O-N-T-R-E-E-A, and the testimony will come up, the Facebook page will come up. I now use my platform to share other people's testimonies.
Awesome.
And
Amen.
You know, the testimonies, we're at over 2 million views. And I just thank God for just changing things around. I just praise God for you, sister. I'm so happy for
so
you.
Welcome. Thank you. Thank you for being my guest here on Healing for the Broken. And if you did not hear it, in order to keep up with Miss Montrea and her ventures and the different things that God is doing in her life, please follow her, Montrea, M-O-N-T-R-E-E-A, Bailey, and just follow Miss Montrea, and just watch what God is going to be doing in her life, and there's more to come. We'll be right back.
Whatever you think you are more than that. You are braver than you believe, stronger than you seem, smarter than you think, and loved more than you know. Join Yvonne Chukwu for Inspire to Aspire on NDTV as she takes you through the Word of God and biblical principles that will enable you to live a life of fulfillment and achieve better results in all your endeavors. Inspire to Aspire. Tune in, and you will be confident.
My name is Candace Blanks, and I'm talking to those people who have been afflicted, abused, rejected, feeling unloved, or just simply gone through life and don't have a way out. Or maybe you have been diagnosed with an illness. Well, I'm here to tell you that God is here for us, and He is healing the broken. So please tune in every day to Healing for the Broken as various people tell and share their heart and testimony. Back, well, we're having an awesome time with my sister in Christ and my sister for real, Miss Montrell Bailey. And so we're going to give Miss Montrell a few words, a few minutes to just speak with you guys about lasting words.
Yes, the closing word I think for today is that you want to understand the consequences of sin, and you want to understand that yes, it feels good. Yes, at times it feels impossible to get out. Bondage is very comfortable. That's the thing with bondage. It don't feel like bondage, but baby, trust me, it is. It's very comfortable. You get so used to it, and you'll take something that God hates and you'll adopt it, and you'll become so in bondage that you'll convince people that God loves it. If you're at that point, this is your time to reach out to God and ask Him to be free. You don't have to fall out and roll over the floor. My bishop talks about tearing service back in the old days. You can just invite Christ into your heart right now. Just ask Him, Father, I don't know. I'm a man. I don't know how to stop. I'm a woman. I don't know how to stop wearing men's clothes. I'm a man that loves to be with men. Can you begin the process today, Father God, of removing the desire? Just ask Him to begin. Don't ask Him all of a sudden, Father God, I want to wake up tomorrow. Father God, I want to be straight. Just ask Him into your heart to begin the process. And just be open to whatever He has for you. Remove the fear. Remove the doubt. Hallelujah, Jesus. Right now, Father God, we're asking you, Father God, to come across these airwaves to anybody, Father God, who's struggling with sexual sin, homosexuality, bisexuality, transsexuality, cross-dressing, pornography, Father, adultery, Lord. Anything that is outside the confines of sin, Father God, outside the confines of your words, Father God. We ask you, Jesus, right now to come into the midst, Lord. We know that you are a healer. We know that you are a deliverer. We know that you do the impossible. And we ask that you begin the process, Lord. That's all that we ask, because we know, Father God, that the Holy Spirit comes into the matter of the situation, Lord. And that process, it begins to stir it, Father God, like a big old gumbo bowl, Lord. It begins to stir all of the ingredients that we need for the peace, Father God, the joy, Father God, the forgiveness, Lord, the mercy, the grace. Lord, Father God, begin that process. Begin a stirring on the inside. A stirring on the inside. Fresh new manna. Fresh new anointing, Father God, so that that gift, Father God, that was once a curse, Lord, Father God, we know, Jesus, you can turn it into a blessing right now, Jesus. We thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
And we ask you in the name of Jesus, we just thank you in advance for the healing that is about to begin right now. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen, Jesus.
Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. So to all of those who feel like there's no way out, God says, yes, there is. It is through me. Accept Him into your life. Romans 10, 9 and 10. Confess with your mouth, believe in your heart that Jesus died and rose again. You shall be saved. And so those people who are out there listening, saying that there's no room for me, we say, yes, there is. You just confess with your mouth and open up your heart to receive Christ in your life. So this is Healing for the Broken. We have come to an end, but please keep tuning in to on Facebook and Instagram, on NDT Network, and also on YouTube at New Dimensions TV. And also you can tune in online at www.ndtv.com. Please be blessed. See you soon. God bless you.
Your feet, all my broken pieces, every load that's carried.
My name is Candace Blanks, and I'm talking to those people who have been afflicted, abused, rejected, feeling unloved, or just simply gone through life and don't have a way out. Or maybe you have been diagnosed with an illness. Well, I'm here to tell you that God is here for us, and He is healing the broken. So please tune in every day to Healing for the Broken as various people tell and share their heart and testimony.
How will you feel when you know that someone is praying and interceding for you every day? That is how we hold our partners with high esteem, standing in the gap and praying for you without season. NDTV is God's plan to transform lives and help people to get their freedom from every form of oppression, walk in victory, discover their original destiny and the plan of God for them. Together, we can do far more than any of us could ever do alone. Become a partner today by visiting www.ndtvn.com/partnership, and you will be glad you did.
Elijah Adeniyi, CPA, handling your taxes, accounting, and other financial services, serving the greater Houston area. From business taxes to income taxes, payroll and bookkeeping services, financial statements, audit reports, and more. Helping entrepreneurs in Houston register their businesses with the state of Texas. Tax season is now. Call today and get a head start on your taxes. Exemptions, deductions, tax credits. Call today and find out if you qualify. Receive one-on-one consultation. Aiming to properly document taxable income and avoid the common pitfalls of the average taxpayer. Let your finances be professionally handled so that you can focus on other important things. Business owners, don't let your idea die. Call today and see how to get registered with the state of Texas. Work in the system, but don't let the system work you. Elijah Adeniyi, CPA, helping you handle your money the right way.
For the earnest expectation of the creature wait for the manifestation of the sons of God. Romans 8:19. There is a star in you. Join Pastor Adam on The Star in You. You will learn what it takes to expand your vision, transform your way of thinking, take your eyes off yourself and your current circumstances, discover the genius in you, and make your world a better place. The Star in You. Broadcasting soon on NDTV. Tune in, and you will be blessed.